please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
The Parliamentary Standing Committee on Housing and Urban Affairs has been quite critical of the Urban Development Ministry's utilization of funds for six flagship schemes, including PMAY, Smart City, Amrit and Swachh Bharat. The panel has highlighted that only one-fifth of the released amount has been spent and these much-hyped schemes may remain a distant dream. Hardeep Singh Puri, MOS Housing and Urban Development, joins me now. Thank you so much for speaking with CNBC TV 18, sir.
It's always a pleasure to speak to you.
All right, sir. My first question is, how do you respond to the Parliamentary Committee's strong criticism of low fund utilization for the key urban and housing schemes?
Well, first of all, Manisha, let me start by placing on record my appreciation for parliamentary scrutiny. I'm a member of parliament, and I always encourage members of parliament to look at ongoing schemes with due diligence and rigor. But I must respectfully submit that there are ways and ways in which you look at figures. My problem with the flagship programs is not the slow rate of implementation. I think the flagship programs are roaring. My issue with them is to find the money to meet the very ambitious targets. I would encourage people to look at figures a little more scientifically. Now, for instance, in some schemes, they look at what is called a utilization certificate. Now, anyone with even a nodding acquaintance of how governments function know that utilization certificates are sent by government departments sometimes 24 months after the expenditure has been booked. Let me therefore provide a perspective for you in which so that you will be able to understand the rate of implementation. Let's start with Swachh Bharat Mission. Let's take the number of toilets to be built under the Swachh Bharat Mission, the urban segment with which I am associated. Total target is 67 lakh toilets. We've done already 52 lakhs, and that this has to be completed by 2019, 2nd October. I'm quite confident that we can get all 67 lakh toilets built by October or November this year, 1 year in advance. Similarly for community toilets. Then let me come to Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana. The target here is that we have to build a total of, say, 11 to 12 million homes so that every Indian citizen will have a home which he or she can call their own by 2022, with the title being in the name of the lady of the house or co-jointly. Now, we are sanctioning, or we are under pressure to sanction something like 300,000 to 500,000 homes every month under different verticals. Let me give you the targets. I think by March of 2018, that is in a few days' time, we would have already sanctioned something between 4.3 million and 4.5 million. And the overall target is 11 million to be completed by 2022. My problem here is not slow implementation. My problem here is money. We were getting 6,000 crores in the budget last year. That has been raised to 6,500 crores under Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana. That is not sufficient to provide the funds required under the four verticals. So what have we done? We have set up an affordable housing fund, which the finance minister announced in the budget speech. And then subsequently, I've got cabinet approval for an affordable housing fund for 60,000 crores. And we've just got 8,000 crores from the small savings fund. We have to go to extra budgetary resources. So if you are carrying out a scheme on this scale, money is what is required. And therefore, with due respects to my honorable colleagues in parliament who looked at this, must have been sometime earlier. Again, let me give you the smart cities thing. It's like this. The funding in smart cities has to follow a certain pattern. We don't do project-wise funding. What we do is, when a smart city is conferred that title through competitive bidding, and in the process which started in June 2015, the first 20 cities were named only in January 2016. Mm-hmm. Then another 20 later. Last nine were named only a few days ago. Now, what happens in this situation? Quite simply, it takes 18 months before a special purpose vehicle is set up. After 18 months, once a special purpose vehicle is set up, they have to then have a consultant, then they have to tender for specific projects.
Right,
now,
sir.
The question that should be asked is, out of the 99 cities which have smart city status, how many of them have special purpose vehicle? Manisha, the answer is 89. Now, from my point of view, that's very good. Now, if you started in sometime in January 2016, when you were named, and you are now, you have done something like 24 months, first 18 months get taken up by the whole process of setting up
right,
a special
sir.
Purpose vehicle.
And
so
you
what
have
you
mentioned
should do
that
is
to us before.
Look at the amount
well.
Of money on hmm. which projects are completed. Exactly, exactly.
Okay,
exactly.
All right, sir. So then, you know, you've raised a very important point, and let me come to that then. The Parliamentary Committee did say that it is a matter of serious concern that the flagship programs of the government, which are widely publicized, have actually been sidelined in the budget. So this 63,000 crore rupees that you've mentioned, sir, which NHP and HUDCO are supposed to raise, are you confident you'll be able to raise it?
Now, for instance, the budget does not have to provide for every flagship program. Very often, countries in the world, including us, we raise money on the market. Here, we have already established a fund for 60,000 crores on Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana. I mean, if I were to insist, and if I somehow had a margin of persuasion with a finance minister, I mean, a central budget would be in deep trouble. I mean, I'm just meeting my schemes. There are other ministers who have schemes. So, look. With due respect to any suggestion that the budget doesn't provide the money, budget has to provide funds for a large number of schemes. As long as I have money to implement the flagship programs, I'm satisfied. And now I can tell you, I'm not just satisfied. These flagship schemes are roaring. I mean, I'm having difficulty, not difficulty, I'm putting it lightly. I have to keep pace with the demand which is generated. So whenever any chief minister comes to me, I had one yesterday, they're all saying, all right, we need money for this, we need money for that. Yes, I'm totally confident that we have the ability to raise money through extra budgetary sources, if necessary, from the market. We haven't got to that state yet. But I am deeply committed to meeting the targets under the flagship programs, and I'm happy to discuss those targets with you.
All right, so final question. The report also notes that the revenue expenditure up to 31st December is about 83%, sir, but capital expenditures only 65%, and it actually says that doesn't augur well for overall financial management of the ministry. Your response, sir?
No, hold on. If revenue expenditure is 85% is by December, I don't know what it means in terms of managing finances. I mean, I'm not clear. I mean, if you have to spend the money and you're spending 85 on the revenue on capital expenditure, look, you don't incur capital expenditure till it's ready to be spent. I mean, I'm not going to release money unless the project for which it is utilized is doing that. And I'm just telling you, on the smart city side, on other capital expenditure, you have to be careful. So now if you look at what is being budgeted and what we are supplying, that is what is important.
Right, sir. Well, thank you so much for speaking with CNBC TV 18, sir. Good to have your response to all those criticisms. And like you said, a scrutiny by a parliamentary committee is quite important, but...
I don't think they're criticism. Those are interpretations, Manisha. They're not criticisms. Please read the report carefully yourself. I mean, you know, and you read what it is that they are saying. And then accordingly, I wish Parliament were allowed to run. I would clarify it on the floor of the House.
Controversy over Facebook data breach by voter profiling company Cambridge Analytica to influence voters during US presidential election is spreading like wildfire. Authorities across the globe are monitoring the details, and several agencies in the US and Europe are initiating investigations into this matter. Also, delete Facebook hashtag is trending across the internet, with the likes of WhatsApp co-founder supporting this campaign. The row has also taken a toll on the social media giant's net worth, and some investors are suing the company for this decline in their wealth. The Facebook data breach has in fact triggered a debate in India as well. Law and IT Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad today accused the Congress of roping in Cambridge Analytica to manage its 2019 campaign. The minister asked whether the Congress will depend upon data manipulation and data theft to win elections. Sending a stern warning to social media platforms like Facebook, Ravi Shankar Prasad said that any covert or overt attempt to misuse social media to influence India's electoral process will neither be tolerated nor be permitted.
Mr. Mark Zuckerberg, you better note the observation of the IT Minister of India. We welcome the Facebook profile in India, one of the highest in the world. But if any data theft of Indians is done to the collusion of Facebook system, this shall not be tolerated. We have got stringent power in the IT Act. We shall use it, including summoning you in India. जिस तरह के रास्तों को वो अपनाते हैं, सेक्स स्लीव एंड फेक न्यूज, क्या कांग्रेस पार्टी हिंदुस्तान के वोटरों को प्रभावित करने के लिए इनके माध्यम से वही रास्ते अपनाने जा रही? लेट मिस्टर राहुल गांधी एक्सप्लेन. ऑफ लेट ही इज क्वाइट एक्टिव इन द सोशल मीडिया. व्हाट इज द रोल ऑफ कैम्ब्रिज एनालिटिका इन द सोशल मीडिया प्रोफाइल ऑफ राहुल गांधी?
इंडियन नेशनल कांग्रेस or the Congress president have never used and never hired the services of the company called Cambridge Analytica mentioned by the Union Law Minister. This is a fake agenda, a white lie being dished out on fake facts by the Law Minister, unfortunately. And this has become a daily order with the Law Minister, Shri Ravi Shankar Prasad.
And it's not only in India.